For today's best fish dissection ever, I bring you the steelhead trout. In the description, you'll find worksheets to label, or do what I do and draw and label your own fish. Pause the video if I'm going too fast. Let's learn how to measure fish. We take the total length, fork length, or the standard length. Let's label our fish axes. Onto our external anatomy and label the fins. In most bony fish, the fins are supported by rays of dermal bone, rather than cartilage, which you saw from the sturgeon dissection video. What else can we label on the external fish anatomy? Another characteristic of the bony fish is the operculum, a bony plate that protects the gills. It can be opened or closed to push water across the gills. Here is a common test question. What are two main functions of the gills? The answers are in the description below. For those doing your own fish dissection, here's a pro tip. Be sure to use the blunt edge of the scissors when cutting into the body cavity to prevent organ damage. I'm going to start my dissection by cutting from the anus towards the anterior portion of the steelhead. Farm fish tend to have a lot of body fat when compared with wild fish because they have easier access to food and they usually don't get as much exercise. What else can we see of the eternal fish anatomy? To see the gallbladder, which is dark green in color, you'll need to tease the liver out of the way. Once the gastrointestinal tract has been moved, we can get a good look at the gas bladder. Notice the paired testes that run along the ventral surface of the gas bladder. I've cut the gas bladder away so we can have a clear view of the steelhead trout's kidneys. UC Davis Aquaculture, I'm Dr. Jackson Gross, and this has been the best fish dissection ever.